Hi, this is Yogesh.
In this lecture, I'm going to cover what is a Razor engine, then Razor engine syntax, then we'll also see a difference between Razor engine and aspx engine. Razor view engine, it is a MVC subsystem which has its own markup. It is not a new programming language, but it used to convert your server side template into HTML markup and it render it to browser. So let's say if I want to write down any server side object inside my CHTML page, then we use a Razor engine syntax. A Razor engine file extension is .cshtml. So initially ASP.NET MVC uses a web form engine, but from MVC 3 version they have introduced a Razor engine. Let's see some common Razor engine syntax. So I'm going to cover a single statement block, then the multi-statement block, then the condition statement, as well as looping. So let's open project. So I'm going to create another controller. So right click on a controller, say add new controller and choose the empty controller template. We'll give the name of this controller is Razor sample controller. Let's create a view for this. Say add view. Fine. So I have already have some code for this. So let's copy that code. So you can see your Razor engine start with a @ keyword. So if you want to comment anything, then we can say @*, then *@. So we'll start with a single statement block statement. So here in the @ section, we declare a one message variable, and inside that we just put this hardcode string that is a hello, welcome to Razor View engine. If I want to display this message, then we can use again the @ message. Second one is a multi-statement block. So here we can write down a multiple statement inside this Razor block. So again, I start with the @start block. Here we declare a 3 variable pi radius, and then we'll just calculate this area of circle using a pi into radius. So let's say if I want to print this area of circle, so remember this area of circle radius pi. So these are the server side variables, and I want to write down the server side variable inside the CHTML. So here we use the Razor engine. So you can see area of circle is @ area of circle. The next statement is a conditional statement. So here I set one flag is true. This condition is always true, and based on this condition we are just displaying it's an if statement in code block. So basically I try to convey that how we write down the Razor syntax inside the CHTML page. So just below here we have a single block, and we'll display it is a single if block, and we have use one conditional looping statement. So let's say I have a one for loop, and inside this for loop we just increment our count variable up to 3, and then we are just displaying this. So remember, when we start our Razor syntax, and let's say if any HTML element come, then again we need to start from the @ block. So here this loop is iterate till count 3, and it display a 1, 2, and 3. Finally, we have a string array which contains these 4 record. So if I want to print this array, then we use a for each block. So var name in name array, and then here one by one we display the name.
Let's run this application.
Fine. So you can see here we have the first message, that's a hello, welcome to Razor View engine. We have a multi-statement block. Here we just calculate the area of circle. Then we have a conditional statement. So here I just assign my variable to true, and then based on that it is just displaying this data. It's an if statement in a code block. So you can see over here. Then we pass the true value inside this if block, and it is just displaying the it is a single if block. And finally in the looping we have used a for as well as a for each loop. So the Razor engine is giving you, or it allow you to write down your server side coding inside your CHTML part, and that's why you are getting a complete control over the HTML. Finally, we need to see a difference between a Razor engine and aspx engine. Razor engine is introduced in MVC3 version, but before that we have a aspx engine. So we'll just see a major difference between these two. Razor engine, it makes a writing a dynamic content on our MVC view easier using a @ keyword. Means whenever we start any server side scripting or server side template, then we just start with a @ sign. So because of that, your code is very clean. But if you compare with the aspx engine, previously we use a %%, %greater than. So this delimiter basically we have to use, and because of that our code is a messy code. That's why it is very difficult to write down a code in aspx engine. Second point, Razor engine doesn't support a design view in a Visual Studio to view your page look and feel. But in a aspx engine, it supports the design view in a Visual Studio to view page look and feel. Okay, so in this lecture, we have seen what is the Razor engine, then its simple syntax. Then we have also covered what is the difference between Razor engine and aspx engine.
Thank you for watching.